You know this story. In the early years of World War II, Nazi Germany swept across Europe. Then the Germans invaded the Soviet Union, but after the defeat at Stalingrad, the tide began to turn, and especially after the landing of the Allied troops on D-Day, Hitler's armies lost more and more battles and retreated until they surrendered in 1945. Hello, my dear friends, how are you? I'm Felipe Castanhari, and whenever we talk about history, we get that curiosity of, what if? What if the Roman Empire had never fallen? What if the Soviets had reached the moon before the Americans? These are just a few questions, but without a doubt the most famous of them is, what if the Nazis had won the Second World War? This question makes people so curious that there are books, films, series, and games portraying this subject. Each author has their own vision, because it is impossible to answer this question exactly. There are so many variables, right? But we can think about some things and extrapolate some facts that we know. Especially thinking about Hitler's plans for a victorious Nazi Germany. And before showing you this world ruled by Nazis, I wanted to ask you to leave your like below and also subscribe using the button. Click there and subscribe so you don't miss any videos and can support the channel. And if you want to support even more, if you are an even more incredible person, there is a become a member below. Click there and become a member of the channel and receive videos before everyone else. You may have your name in the credits, depending which plan you choose, and helps us a lot to produce these animation videos that are a lot of work. Then that's it. Let's now explore our alternative world. And if you don't know anything about World War II, there's a link here in the description to our cool and complete video about World War II. Go watch it and then come back here. You are watching Animated History. So let's pretend the Nazis defeated the Soviet Union and also defeated England. Let's also pretend that the United States never entered this war. So Japan never attacked Pearl Harbor, which means the Americans never dropped the two atomic bombs on Japan. So we didn't have D-Day and Hitler managed to conquer all of Europe. What would happen from then on? We will see. In this reality in 1945, the main power in Europe would be Nazi Germany, but it would not be the only one. Mussolini's Italy would continue to exist, but only occupying the lands that Hitler allowed, such as North Africa. Portugal and Spain, which had fascist governments, would probably be independent states, but completely submissive to Hitler. Okay, but what about Eastern Europe? Well, with the fall of the Soviet Union, Hitler would occupy the territory up to the line of the Ural Mountains, thus he would capture the Russians' oil reserves and transform all of Eastern Europe into an agricultural area, with the Slavic people being forced to do forced labor in German farms. This was the living space that Hitler said Germany needed. Furthermore, Germany would recover the colonies it lost in the First War and conquer the French and English colonies spread across the planet. With all these swastikas spread across the map, the Nazis' conquest of the Middle East would be easy. In the First War, Germany wanted this region within its area of influence. Here in this reality, Hitler would conquer this oil by force. Dominating Europe, the colonies, and the areas of influence of their former rivals, the Nazis would expand their domains into the African and Asian continents, gaining even more forced labor. Yes, in the world dominated by Nazism, people forced into forced labor would be something very common. This Nazi rule would result in millions of deaths, especially among Jews who escaped the Holocaust. Extermination camps would be built in all places dominated by Germany. This final solution, the gas chambers, the Nazi concentration camps, would even change the map of the Middle East, because the State of Israel would never have been created. Freedom of the press and expression would simply cease to exist in these places, and every work of art in school would have to praise Nazism and the Aryan race. Anyone seen as an enemy of the regime, such as communists, gypsies, and homosexuals, would be murdered. Public execution would be common, and cruel medical experiments would be practiced everywhere by the Nazi government. Another important change would be the absence of the UN on the planet. The United Nations was created after World War II in place of the League of Nations. Hitler would probably create a council among his allies, where he would have all the major decision-making powers. But what about Japan in this whole story? Well, without facing the United States in war, the Japanese would have dominated the Pacific, controlling most of Oceania and Asia. They would do well with a Nazi victory, because as the lands beyond the Ural Mountains do not have many resources, Hitler would probably allow Japan to have the eastern part of the Soviet Union. This would give Japan breathing room to do something that Hitler would love to do, end China. The Chinese and Japanese had been at odds for a long time and China would be easy prey for this Japanese empire, which did not lose the war and would still be supported by Germany. With China occupied, Japan and Germany would be united even geographically, so the war would never have ended until we had only three great powers on the map: the German Reich, the Japanese Empire, and the United States. So, where would the world go after that? Probably toward a Cold War between Americans and Nazis, much like what happened between the United States and the Soviet Union, with the two powers competing for areas of influence. And do you know what one of the main stages of this conflict would be? It's boy, Latin America and the Caribbean. Americans would want to maintain control over these countries considered the backyard of the United States. The Japanese would want to dominate all countries that have a Pacific coastline, and Germany would exploit the economic riches of these countries, in addition to militarily threatening the United States with its neighbors. But as a large part of the Nazi economy revolved around armaments and militarization, this war was unlikely to remain cold for long, and the Nazis would begin to invade countries that they had not yet conquered. So if the Americans had not participated in World War II, they would have been thrown into World War III, facing the Germans and their Japanese allies. And historians find it very difficult to bet on who would have atomic weapons in a scenario like this. The most likely would be the United States, as many scientists involved in this research were Jews who fled to America. But would the Americans have developed an atomic bomb so quickly, without having participated in World War II? We have no way of knowing this part for sure. If the Americans were the first to create atomic bombs, we would probably have nuclear explosions not only in Japan, but in Germany, with the Americans fighting their two enemies. Now, if these weapons were never invented in the hands of the Nazis, the United States would probably do very badly in this war, as they would have to fight on different fronts against various enemies, until they were defeated by Germany and Japan. We would get screwed in this one too, because Latin Americans would be seen by the Nazis as an inferior race, and it is very likely that we would be sentenced to forced labor. But the story doesn't end there. The Nazi objective revolved around Aryan racial superiority. And Japan was not part of these plans. Thus, after defeating the United States, there would be a dispute between Germany and Japan for world domination. We would then have the Fourth World War between the only two powers that remained. The result? The Nazis with more land and resources would probably be the winners and thus dominate the entire planet, because smaller fascist states like Italy, Spain and Portugal would certainly have been absorbed by the Reich at some point. The entire planet would then be Hitler's. In fact, the swastika would even be on the moon. The Americans only set foot on the moon thanks to Nazi rocket technology, and here it would be the Nazis who would do it. Of course, we would have scattered pockets of resistance against German rule. A role similar to today's terrorists, but as the Nazis had no shame in bombing cities and exterminating thousands of civilians, these movements would be hunted until they were completely exterminated. You would only have to walk through any major city in the world to see Hitler's face. He would be on posters, newspapers, cinemas, and military parades. Perhaps this story ended precisely because of the fact that Nazism was a regime whose greatest symbol was Hitler, but the German dictator would not live forever. Would this global Nazism continue to exist after Hitler's death? Perhaps revolts against this oppressive government would begin to explode like this, and he would die, or there would be no coming back from a planet dominated by the Nazis, forever marking the destiny of humanity? What do you think would happen in this nightmare world? Tell me in the comments. Well, this version of the world doesn't seem good, right? Like I said, this is just an idea. There is no guarantee that things would actually happen that way. But it's always good to do this exercise to understand how an oppressive government would harm all of humanity. And if you like this type of video, where I explore an alternative future for our planet, please leave a like, subscribe below, You can become a member to receive this video before everyone else and have your name here too. Just click the button below to become a member and you will help me a lot. And don't worry, don't go away, because you need to watch this video about the Second World War if you haven't seen it yet. You also need to watch our latest video from this playlist, where we show how much trash there is in the world and where this trash goes, it's very interesting. And also our video about racism, the history of structural racism, what it means, click here and you will understand. Thank you for listening, take care, goodbye.